We have, it's an exciting game. This is your world champs Ascended against Exodia, who has clawed their way through this winner's bracket up to these winners finals right here. Both of these teams are going to be competing in Unite Rivals, and we'll see if one of them takes Alolan Ninetales into the jungle, Chris.
Oh, that's that would be very cool. Honestly, it's very fun. I think it's actually better than you think it is. It is a insane Pokemon. So many stuns. Once that we see Urshifu. Has that been picked a lot this tournament?
What is this? Why are we getting Eldegoss bans? Is there something?
Oh, Eldegoss ban again. Exodia just both teams banned Eldegoss.
Both teams banned Eldegoss. What is
all
happening?
Right. Very interesting. I can't tell you why that is, but we have a lot of OP Pokemon being picked now. Shifu, Mew, Mime, Dodrio, Scyther, and potentially a Slowbro as well. Blissey still also, no one picks Blissey when Eldegoss is banned. That is also very interesting, right?
Yeah, I wonder what we're going to see here. We've got Scyther, we've got Slowbro, and possibly Snorlax on the side of Exodia. Oblivion on that Mew, which we've seen be absolutely dominant today. Let's see, Ascended, we are grabbing Blissey here, and then one final
about time.
Pokemon.
What's it going to be? A Gardevoir, a Glaceon, a Venusaur? Could also be pretty good.
Oh, and you know what? We might not be
it's
on the same
be Venusaur.
Time, I'm realizing.
18, 17, 16,
no.
15, 14?
No, I'm actually behind you. 17, 16, okay. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10.
10, 9.
Oh,
okay. Anything. Preparation phase. And a Tyranitar. So again, just 5 melee Pokemon for a team. Well, again, Slowbro. We can consider Makana range Pokemon. But you know what I mean. Very beefy Pokemon.
Extremely beefy. Heading in here to game number one, your world champs versus Exodia, a team that maybe has not been on a lot of people's radar, but they're going to have to
for
be
sure
today.
Not. Yeah, they made it to the top four already. And now they have fight for seeding and a grand final spot in the qualifier. So
we have gone
very
from Sableye being banned every game to Sableye not being banned and being picked, to Sableye not being banned and not being picked, to Eldegoss being banned inside of games.
That's our Shin Evolution and through this tournament.
It's wild. It's wild to see. But this is what happens with a pick and ban. You know, as teams start to draft and come up with different strategies, it's pretty exciting to see. Let's see how Exodia fares against the current reigning champions of Pokemon Unite.
Yeah, and what a surprise there in this winner's final, especially having very, very insane teams in the bracket as well. But they're the ones making it through, and they're going to face Dao Hash looking towards the jungle with the Scyther, top lane, Lavitar, Snorlax. Going to try to get Tyranitar as fast as possible, which is always going to be very difficult, especially against a Mew. They're sending Mew towards the top side.
Huh. Yeah, that is a little different from what we've seen. Now we're clearing out the center area together. Overlord getting its level 4 right now. Blissey walking top. Oblivion there. I mean, it's just going to be able to punish this Tyranitar for sure. I don't know how you're ever going to out-secure a Mew with T-Tar. At least it's
but
got that big
bite. But he went for the Electro Ball light screen. So a bit of a different approach, but it also does a lot of damage. Anything with light screen touches does a lot of damage if it goes through. And the Electro Ball as well. Look at this damage right now. Oh my god, the Lavitar dropping so low already. And that's exactly what we need for all of Oblivion right here. Looking for this last hit as well.
Gosh.
And here we go. The damage is ridiculous right now. Out of this view already in this early game. Lavitar, look, I might find a KO, but no Electro Ball on both of this Pokemon. This Focus Band is going to save Snorlax. And now the Light Screen also pushing Scyther away. Light Screen is so annoying as well. That stun is always just so annoying.
Jeez, look at this Mew just absolutely crushing it right here. Trying to pick up some of that experience, but it looks like Exodia is able to grab all of that. As their central area Pokemon has made it to the top path right here. Dual Wing Beat lands, but they are going to back off of this goal. Ooh, maybe they're looking for something sneaky. Nope, actually heading back down as we have 3-on-1 in this bottom path. Massive Wicked Blow. Rex is in a lot of trouble, and they do go down as they
gone.
Are scoring on this goal here.
He's going to try and score 14, but Snorlax is here from the flank. Does he have the Tekke? I mean, he sure has the Tekke, but he actually doesn't hit it. So maybe Slash can get away now. The Tekke did not reach. And he's just going to run away. No Curious has the gear drain. I don't think he's going to die. He's going to start auto-attacking a lot. Has the Rapid Fire Scarf, I'm pretty sure as well. Very good item on Venusaur. It's always funny to see Rapid Fire Scarf be so good on so many special attack Pokemon as well.
Yeah, just getting that massive boosted with those vines is incredible.
Yeah.
It stuns Pokemon out of their moves. It does insane damage. Here we go. Bora moving in here, still a level 6 Tyranitar, Relentless trying to get some of that, and a massive Solar Beam just pushing everyone out of that central area right here. So we move back down to this bottom path. Now everyone's just going to be playing a little Stardew Valley, just doing a little farming until the next big objective in about 20 seconds when these birds spawn top and bottom.
That's a very aggy Pupit time. He wants this KO, but Focus Band of Blissey is going to keep Blissey alive. There's so many Focus Bands always in these games as well. Such a good item. Very annoying to play against as well, because you can never tell if it's up or not. That's the most annoying part about it. You also can't tell if your opponents have it until they actually have it. Overlord with a nice KO here on the Dodrio. His first appearance, I feel like, in this match. But my Slash Cannon is going to go down. And also, this Ivysaur is very, very deep. Overlord just farming these Altarias with the big blow. He's going to throw chop it again. Maybe even too deep. The double hit's going to land on him. Do we have another heavy slam? The Unstoppable is there from the big blow. And he walks away and picks up two berries.
Looking pretty good here at the 7-minute mark. And Overlord actually doing okay here, just getting that safeguard from the Blissey as they're moving forward, trying to pick up this KO on Rex, trying to be pushed back by this tri-attack, deciding whether or not Relentless actually wants to go in and fight this here. We do have Regirock up here in this bottom path. Overlord moving down so it can have that massive secure. It also has its Unite move available, so it can take someone into the sky. Is it going to look for it on the Scyther here? I'm not sure. Regirock is gone. I don't know who got it. It's just completely gone. So are all the members of Ascendant.
Yeah, and three KO Aldry for Scyther, and it actually went over to Urshifu, of course. It went over to Urshifu in the end, but Exodia with a huge teamfight win, which I think, again, is more important. All these KOs and scoring afterwards is so much more experience than getting the Regi, so I think they're going to be very, very happy about this. There was so much damage coming in, I think just Scyther happened, right?
Yeah, it looks like Scyther happened in such a massive way here. Dodrio's in a lot of trouble, actually using its Unite move to hopefully get away from this, taking a big boosted, but it is able to get out as Snorlax is getting pushed down here to this goal. Big block. We got four members of Ascended fighting on this goal right now. One of them happens to be in Urshifu. Oh, sorry, is that five members of Ascended actually crashing on this bottom goal with a really amazing overdunk here? 39 points.
Yeah, for sure. 123 points now for Ascendant. But we still have a Venusaur. There we go. There's the evolution done for the Venusaur. Experience still looks quite even, but we don't outside have a Tyranitar yet. And as I say that, also we have the Tyranitar done. So everyone is kind of evolved now and looking to start team fighting. Slowbro missing its Unite move. Looking for level 9. Besides that, everyone else is slowly getting there as well. Mime also still looking for the Unite move. Slash Ken not having the greatest early game yet. Overlord's kind of caught off position. He's going to get taken down. Just stuck in between four members. Going a bit too deep right there.
Once again, I do think that's probably that Tyranitar working against that Wicked Blow resistance right there. I do need to get that confirmed for everybody, yeah. But I believe that's how it's going to work. Massive Solar Beam. Snorlax moving in here with a huge block. Here come the Unite moves onto the Scyther. We have a Bliss assistance. Dodrio pushing into the back line right here, but it's having to run out as it looks like Exodia is actually being pushed out of this fight. Venusaur now running in, trying to pick up all of these KOs. Tyranitar moving towards this Regieleki. We have a Unite move being thrown down, secured actually by that Venusaur as it continues to run forward, chasing down the Scyther, chasing down the Slowbro. The whole team is crashing on this top goal, and now it's time to do a little math as Ascended wins this fight in a big way.
Yeah, doing some math right here, and yeah, I think they're doing good. It's going to be a nice overcap. Yeah, that has been great. They all kind of score their points in. 233 points now for this head of Ascendant. Venusaur 11.5. When this Pokemon gets to level 13, it pretty much is unkillable, right? That Petidense plus reaching so many characters, also just making Gear Drain such a low cooldown. He's getting caught a bit right here, but again, Gear Drain is being hit. He has another Gear Drain. Heavy Slam lands on him, though. He gets Chain CC'd by the Dodrio Unite as well. And he's actually getting taken down. As I just say, he's unkillable. Instantly shows that he can also stay go down. Urshifu removing in. Obviously, Big Blow is taking not a lot of damage because of the Big Blow. Scyther's diving in very, very deep. He gets Blissey. Gets a reset as well. Looking for Overlord now, who's also going to fall thanks to Tyranitar. Moving up further. Double KO for Scyther. Then a score and break the score right here. Mime is trying to buy time with the Unite move. Looking for anything. But really, there's two unstoppable Pokemon right there with Snorlax and Tyranitar. So nothing really happens out of the Dark Pulse. Is going to root Mime in place. Can he get away with the Blissey helping hand? Yes, he can.
Wow. What a fight here from Exodia. That Tyranitar, it feels like it's really doing the work that they needed to do. They're protecting their Scyther really well and actually shutting down Overlord on this Urshifu. I'm kind of surprised, but it feels like they're zoning it out extremely well and KOing it when it runs into any of these fights.
Yeah, for sure. It's not doing out too much yet. So Exodia, I'm very impressed by them. They're really just showing signs of life against the best team in the world currently. So the current world champion of Ascendant. And again, no one had this team on the line, and they're just giving it their best. But Slash Ken might be caught right here. He's going to for sure go down. He's just, I don't know what he's doing over there, just going for a stroll. He's gonna get taken down.
Here we go. Tyranitar's in some trouble here, trying to get out of there with Ancient Power. It actually is able to make it out, but Snorlax might not be able to. Pushing back with the block. They are pushed back. Dodrio still watching this fight, possibly looking to pick up a KO here on Venusaur. It did miss its Giga Drain, so this could be a moment, but it's getting saved there by the Safeguard as they're pushing back up towards this Regieleki. They would definitely like this to be walking towards their Tier 2 right around the time Rayquaza spawned. They're not aware that no one on Exodia cares about this right now, so it looks like they're ripping it pretty fast.
Yeah, for sure. And they're just looking for a bot lane push again. Who cares about Regieleki, but Mr. Mime knows about this and Slash can. Obviously aware that a counter push can happen on the other side of the map. And just defends the goal, pretty much single-handedly. Now Exodia has to base and defend the Regieleki, and they're gonna have very bad positioning for this Rayquaza fight now. Ascend's gonna be in full control of the mid position.
Wow, they're actually staying up top, dealing with this Regieleki. I wonder, I mean, they already know they're behind on score. I wonder if they should just let this walk, and they do. Moving in towards the central area here.
Totally
it looks
smart.
Like Urshifu is moving in towards this fight, and every team member is just positioning around. Ooh, Slash Can really caught out of position here, Chris.
Are they gonna slow unite move him? I don't think so. It's just the Mr. Mime. Can he unite move at least? He's trying to, he can't unite move. He doesn't get it out. No, Slowbro Knight goes on to Venusaur. Blissey is trying to save it. True damage is going to land through the shields, and Venus just has to run away, which pretty much just means Blissey Knight gets traded for Slowbro Knight. But I think Exodia is totally fine with Tyranitar charging up the Ancient Power again. Blissey's dropping super, super low, has the Helping Hands, going to run away. And the teamfight is still happening. It's Mew's, Mew somehow dies somewhere. Mew's getting picked off. Scythe Knight goes on to Urshifu, but he's taking almost no damage. In the end, does fall. And now Exodia are gonna turn their way onto Rayquaza. Venusaur has to be the hero right now. It's gonna stay alive, gonna hit Giga Drain after Giga Drain into a huge Unite move, hitting 3-4 characters. Mime is also back with the Unite move. They're gonna kill one, they're gonna kill two. Or they can Scythe do right here. Venusaur still almost full HP, going for the Tyranitar. The two late game raid bosses fighting against each other, but Venusaur's gonna be the bigger raid boss. He takes all of them, only Scythe has left. One more basic attack. Gonna take down Exodia in this team fight. My god.
I really didn't expect Venusaur was going to be able to do that. We all know what Venusaur could do, but I thought the Tyranitar was going to be able to rip through that. We could see
That's
this
crazy.
Is getting very low. Rex is in here right now looking for the secure with the surf. Not able to get it. Over enters Shifu. Ascended takes that huge Unite move. Goodbye, Scyther. GG. Ascended with a big win here in game one. Gosh, that felt so close for Exodia until that big dinosaur entered the fight. Venusaur just cleaning everything up.
Yeah, that was amazing. Wow. But again, Exodia having, you know, giving up a great fight, really.
Yeah, great fight from Exodia. And
it was just raid boss against raid boss. It was Venusaur late game against late game Tyranitar, pretty much in the end.
Exodia ascended your winners finals. 0-1 ascended your world champs. Exodia, the underdog story, the team we didn't know would make it all the way up there, as we see now some real bands coming out, Blissey and Urshifu. And we have a first pick over to Exodia. Feels like they're probably going to snatch up that site.
They better first pick Edigos right now. I'm going to be
wow,
mad.
They
exactly
really
that is. I mean, they have to do it. If they ban it, they have to pick it, right? They think it's this strong that they have to just play it. And then we get a Bliss, a Mr. Mime, and a Mew for Self-Ascendant.
What am I missing here, Chris? I think it's a great Pokemon.
Don't
know. Get me wrong.
I really think
it's great, but what am I missing?
Maybe they don't want to deal with the top lane red buff Edigos.
Maybe.
Is that it?
Yeah. I guess. Plus,
maybe that top laner is like, I guess I don't want to play against this anymore. Stop it. Just get rid of it. I don't want to do it. Like, Overlord is like, please stop it. Or, like, please, man, just get this rip buff away from us. I can't take it anymore.
I guess it's a real
stick.
Problem.
If I go stick, I'm dead every single time. See, that might be it.
It looks like Bora, yeah, back on their comfort pick there of Tyranitar. They've been playing a mean Tyranitar.
No, we see Clefable, right? Oh, yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah, Zorark again.
Zorark. And then now we have a final pick here from Ascended. We'll see who they want to grab in this last spot. They're thinking about possibly jungling that Delphox, maybe? Or putting it in path.
Glaceon. Okay.
All right.
Looking good. Looking strong. Ascended does look quite squishy, though. They do look quite squishy, which a faint Zorark is going to like. That much I can tell you.
This is an exciting build on Zoroark. You've essentially got the Dodrio build on a Zoroark.
Kind of want to try that. Floatstone double stacking.
Yeah.
Does sound quite nice.
It might be. It might be the
way. We thought maybe Razor Claw is a good item in it, but the thing is, Razor Claw in Zoroark is weird because you pretty much don't auto-attack. Night Slash, you just combo your Night Slashes, and it doesn't reproc, so you get only one Razor Claw at the start of Night Slash. Unless you maybe Shadow Claw in between. And for this bit as well, you kind of just do feint, other move, feint, other move, feint, other move, and you don't basic attack on it, right? So, for sure, quite interesting. Razor Claw does help with landing phase a lot. It makes the aura very strong. You can proc it quite often, especially with that one move. I forget how it's called. I have no idea. The one where it hits, and then you can use it again. It's a lot of early game damage. Fury Stripes, I mean, I'm pretty sure. Maybe?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
That sounds about
it,
right, yeah.
Feels like it should be double slash or something like that.
Yeah, probably.
Given that it's two hits, but it's probably Fury Swipes.
Yeah. And what laning do we have? The Senate lanes look very strong. Scyther Mime topside. Bot lane, we have a Snorlax and a... Was it? What's the other one? A Mew. So that is very strong laning phase for the side of Extended. On the other side, we have a Zora and a Lavitas. So much different story.
Here we have that Eldegoss moving up and slash saying, no, go away. Can't come in.
Open the door,
beautiful,
but no.
Wall right there from Slash. You love to see it. Overlord's like, thank you for letting me get a stack right here. There's nothing else I can do against this red buff Gossifleur.
Yeah, but they do lose that last hit as well. This Lavitas is so aggressive right now. He just wants to fight. He has to be careful not to go down right here. Goes for the last hit, but what an early game by Kyaros. He's already topside so fast with that Glaceon, and I think this one's also going to go down right here. The Gossifleur has no chance. Dodrio, can he find a KO? He's right there with the tri-attack. But no, can't quite find any KO. It's not enough damage there to get Overlord.
Ooh, really close to getting Overlord here.
Yeah, for sure.
He probably could have pushed in that last moment there and grabbed him, but of course it's
he doesn't
want
to risk it, right? It's, if he dies there, the game might just be over instantly. So he doesn't want to risk it. The risk reward is just not worth it. Going for one KO there. And he takes an ice into the face. Has to run back to the jungle. Slash can probably also has to base or just spin around on the goal a tiny bit. If you actually spin outside of inside of the goal, you actually heal faster. There's also a neat trick you can do in laning phase to get your HP a bit faster back up. And now Hash is looking for an invade right here, but Snorlax knows about it. And wisely enough, he's going to back off. But they're going to put Snorlax now. Can he get away? There's the fainted tick in with the slash. And they're going to pick up a easy KO there. Onto the Snorlax.
Snorlax might be in trouble right here as the Zoroark's deciding whether or not they want to go in and try to pick up this Glaceon here. Actually pulling back down to the center. Oblivion coming up with the Mew as they're taking down this Slowbro right here. Tyranitar just looking to get its experience. It's level 5 now, but it's still quite a bit behind. Needs a lot.
It still needs a lot of experience to actually do something in this match. And highest level right now is the Scyther on 07. So Overlord having a good time top right here. And we don't even have an Eldegoss yet. The Eldegoss that is banned is not even an Eldegoss yet. Goes over to a Bytornoy on the left side to finally get the evolution done. And Relentless is going to get taken down by the Snorlax. Couldn't find a KO. And they actually lose their 2v3 on bot side apparently. So Mew and Snorlax holding this lane quite well. Of course, such strong Pokemon together, right? They don't even have to evolve. They're pretty much insanely strong for level 1 on. Top lane looking for push right here. Can Hash stops Overlord, who's level 8 now with a power stop on him. On his Scyther, he's just going to turn this one around. And there's a Pupit only 6.5. Has absolutely no chance.
Here we go, fighting over these birds right here, seeing what they can get on the side. Overlord going extremely low. Can they get it? No, diving too deep. Here comes the power swap, pushing them back. We actually have 4 at this top goal from Exodia. Are they able to pick up a KO right here? Dodrio is looking for it right here, but with the power swap, with the goal healing, they're back to full health, as Overlord is now almost a level 9 Scyther in this top path. 2 members of Ascended just ripping Regice off the map. Currently, Zoroark coming down to see if they can do something about it, but I think it's going to be too little too late. Glaceon saving that icy wind, and yes, they are able to secure.
Nice try by Relentless, but not enough. He's going to use the final ice slash, maybe get away. Kyrus is not going to chase. He knows that might just not be worth its time. Goes for the Nidhi instead. Doesn't want to overextend right now because Ascendant is in such a good lead, right? They don't have to be too aggressive. They're just going to slowly could take this home. Relentless going in, but I think his feint attack doesn't quite find the target. Has to go back out again. Can feint attack back in. The light slash is there, but not enough damage. They're pretty much all full HP. Can't find the KO and a huge overcap for Ascendant on bot as well. And we are Regilecki. Look at this. Also going in on top. Make 230 points now for the side of Ascendant. And they're just in complete control now on the spec also of Overlord Scyther.
It feels like the match is just coming crashing down right now for Exodia. Nothing is going right as another huge Unite move gets thrown in by Overlord, taking out the Slowbro right there. This goal is almost gone in the top path. 46-264 from Ascended. They are in a commanding position right now, and Exodia is in a lot of trouble.
And unlike earlier, the Zorak just can't fight any KOs right now. He has not done really too much. And that's the problem, right? If your early game is also bad and you just can't find these KOs because Ascendant is playing it smart, they're not getting caught by it, then it's very difficult for Zorak to do much. It has to get KOs. That's what speedsters are there for. They don't have good scaling. They need to find those KOs to get the snowball rolling, and it's just not happening. This match whatsoever. We still have obviously a lot of time left. And their Trinitar is still there. Could always be the carry for Exodia. But not like Ascendant's late game is bad, right? They have a Mime, Glaceon, and a Mew for those late game team fights, which is a lot of damage.
I'm actually surprised that we've got two speedsters on the side of Exodia. Yeah. I didn't even really notice that we have two speedsters. We have Dodrio and we have Zorak. It feels like they are both kind of filling the same role here, and they're just getting shut down, unfortunately. Although we do pick up a massive KO on Scyther there.
He's getting caught off position. It's a lot of experience. Oblivion also in a very, very bad spot, has to boost their own tech. Eldegoss not even Unite move up yet. I really wonder why this Eldegoss has such high priority sometimes in these matches. And they go for the block is going to happen. Eldegoss is super, super deep. It's going to just surf down by the Mew. Heavy slam lands as well. Eldegoss is going to go down. Rex might be the next one to fall. But there's a nice Unite before Slowbro, and they're going to turn it around. Overlord dies the second time this match. And this could be the comeback experience that Exodia needs so desperately. Heavy slam instant again. The Tyranitar is very, very stomping the ground. He wants some KOs. He's going to run around, turn around with the Ancient Power. And they're dropping quite low, but now he can't find the last KOs that he needed. That's not enough damage.
So close there from the Tyranitar. It felt like it could turn on the Mew there. Registeel being ripped apart right now, but it's not going fast enough. Secured actually by the Dodrio here, but Scyther comes in with a big Unite move. Dodrio coming right back with a huge Unite move of its own, ripping down Ascended right here. This is a massive fight, and they really needed this. Big, big win there from Exodia as Dodrio is actually taking it to them right now. They're going to push onto this goal. Nice scores coming in. That's a triple KO for the Dodrio right here as they push even further the forward, chaos. Trying to grab this Scyther again, but no, they pull back now. Nice fight from Exodia.
And now suddenly they're back in the match, right? Zorak also finding a nice KO on Mew. Dodrio almost level 30 now. Trinitar moving also up in the experience. And suddenly the experience is very even. They actually might be even slightly bit ahead. So
one thing for sure is they have been doing a great job at catching Scyther on the side of Exodia. They're just grabbing it every time they can see it into a fight. And now, yeah, levels are looking really good for Exodia as Regieleki should just be pushing towards this tier 2. No one from Exodia is going to try to stop it. Looks like they're just going to try to make a safe defense here at their tier 2. As Zorak might be getting itself into a little bit of trouble. Mime coming in with the big Unite. And we have a big Unite coming in from Scyther as they are actually pushing onto this goal. They just let it walk.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's one maybe clear the goal to open up the base or maybe some counter scoring in late game. Or just sneaking in there. But yeah, Overlord just probably a bit overextended in these fights lately now. Might be caught
again.
Yeah, they're just punishing Overlord. Every single time, he's just being a bit too aggressive. So a few misplays there. Relentz is looking for Mr. Mime with the final slash attack. And no one else is going to fall. They're just punishing Overlord, just being too aggressive.
The Eldegoss diff. I mean, we didn't know what it would be. Maybe it's this Eldegoss diff right here, but you're right. They just keep finding Scyther in such amazing moments for Exodia, and it hasn't been popping off as often as we see Scyther normally in some of these games.
Yeah, for sure. Quite interesting. Off-bay match, and we have bot lane now spawning in pretty much now, but no one's going for it. They're just looking for push on top. Can they get some points into here? They want to break it right before Rayquaza. I'm not sure if that's even the right call to do, I'm going to be honest. Could it be a huge overcap for Rayquaza there, but they close the gap a tiny bit at least. Maybe they just want to be not too far behind in case they win a team fight, which could also be totally fine. But now they have to run towards the second goal if they want to score again. Tyranitar level 13 charging up the Ancient Power, looking for an engage. And now Incendent might have a time to engage as long as the Ancient Power is on cooldown. Tyranitar is actually quite weak. Relentless is looking now for the flank right here on the top right bush. He's being very patient right now. But Eldegoss has to use Unite move, and we have Glaceon falling down instead of Ascended. This could be the fight for Exodia. They're going to maybe find a Slowbro Unite. They have to just go right now. They need to find a Slowbro Unite. They're waiting for Scyther to maybe go in, and Rayquaza stopping under half HP. Relentless Zorak doesn't get really too much done. It's just Dyson taking teamfight. Mew from the left side with the Surf is going to also find two KOs together with the Mr. Mime. Tyranitar is still alive, though. He's looking for Mr. Mime. Is he going to fall? Yes, the Slowbro Unite. I don't like that too much. That was a real Slowbro Unite. I feel like that guy was already kind of dead. And now Rayquaza is getting super low. Who's going to get this one? Oblivion on the other side with him. You're waiting for Bruce. Oh, take on to Electro Ball, and he's going to get it.
Glaceon
gonna get
it with the Electro Ball.
Oh no, Glaceon gets it. Wow, I really thought Mew had it with that Electro Ball.
So
but no, it was actually Glaceon securing it.
What a surprising fight there. I mean, it, yeah, you're right. I think that Slowbro Unite might have been one of the big difference makers there. And also trying to secure in the face of a Mew is just so incredibly difficult. I know Exodia was well aware that they were behind and just wanted to push their advantage right there. Just try. They had multiple members of Ascended down. Maybe they can pick up some KOs right here as Overlord does go down once again. Just able to pick this up. But now we have Mew on a mission. Once again, running in that bottom path. It's playing a different video game. It's playing Metal Gear Solid, maybe even Metal Gear Solid 2. It could be Raiden. We don't know, but it is scoring 100 in the bottom path. So now Exodia is even further behind up here as they have to deal with this Glaceon right now and this Mr. Mime. There's just not enough points. There's just not enough time. Ascended going to take game number two.
And that's going to be the best of three victory for them. And again, Exodia had a chance today. They never gave up. They tried to make it back into this match, and they almost made it back into the match. In the end, the Quasar is going to be the deciding factor. They couldn't even score with it, though, except for Mew in the end with 100 points. So, yeah. Still a very good series. I feel like Overlord just being way too aggressive in this match. I mean, otherwise, I feel like it would have been a bit more one-sided.
Yes, they punished Overlord repeatedly. Another great game from Exodia, but once again, you're running into the world champions, and they play some pretty flawless Pokemon Unite.